This is a film about one of the greatest ballerinas and dancers of our time. Handpicked by Rudolf Nureyev at the age of 19, she was the youngest ever étoile, the highest-ranking female dancer at the Paris Opera Ballet, and later, the star of the Royal Ballet here in London.
Throughout her career, Sylvie Guillem has always fearlessly pursued her own artistic vision, earning a reputation for being uncompromising and the nickname Mademoiselle Non.
I can't feel happy with compromise. You have one life. You know, if you spend your life just doing what people, other people tell you to do, it's not your life, it's their life. I want a mine.
At 48 years old, Guillem remains an imperious physical force and is the closest thing dance has to a Hollywood superstar.
She has a presence, a very great presence.
With Sylvie, there were never any limitations.
She's spectacular.
She's completely unique.
But with an eye on life after dance, Guillem is now reinventing herself as a radical environmental campaigner.
It's an enormous net that doesn't make the difference between a tuna or a shark or whatever. It takes everything, kills everything.
With exclusive access filmed over several months, this film explores what happens when a force of nature becomes a force for nature.
There is not enough fish for Africa, and there is not enough fish for Senegal.
And follows Guillem as she continues to defy her own body, confronting the future while remaining one of dance's most mesmerizing trailblazers. This year has already seen Guillem perform in Australia, Russia, and Italy, with upcoming dates in Singapore and Japan. But when not touring, home is high up in the Swiss mountains.
Well, I guess I'm sensitive to this kind of environment, you know. Strong, beautiful, quiet, except from the for the water. There are some places where I feel comfortable, and this is one of them. It's good because it replaces you a little bit, you know, among these big things we are part of. It's not us only controlling, you know, I need to go there, I need to do that, I need to... No, here it's like, okay, you are not the one who decides all the time. Kuma! She's gonna smell terrible because she's... she found some... What kind of... No. Pousse-toi. C'est bien, reste là.
Okay, I don't have kids. I have dogs. It's fine. I didn't especially want a kid. Okay, no problem. Less problem, in fact, not to have any kids. It's hard enough, you know, take care of yourself. Then on the top of that, if you have to raise kids, especially in the world we are living in, you know, I don't think they're gonna have a nice life.
There are others that feel the same. And this cynicism springs from a recent environmental awakening that's offered a timely new focus for Guillem's unyielding passion. She's become an ardent supporter of a controversial marine protection society called Sea Shepherd. The group's founder, Paul Watson, is a hero to many.
Yeah, this is Paul Watson. Nice to meet you.
But also the world's most wanted eco-warrior, famous for using direct action to expose and confront destructive whaling and fishing practices.
You're in a whale sanctuary and you're assisting in illegal activity. Remove yourself from these waters immediately.
With Sea Shepherd, it's a lot of action. They are on the spot, at sea, or where the problem is, to try to stop it. It's less communication, more action, and it's more like me. It's more what I think. You know, after a while, you have to do things. Otherwise, you can't just sit and wait for the things to be worse and worse.
She's come to Senegal in West Africa as part of a Sea Shepherd recce to discover more about the human and environmental impact of illegal trawler fishing in the country's waters.
The fishermen here, they can't compete with those huge boats who are taking everything, destroying life at sea and life here. The situation is quite
It's quite critical. Traditional fishing communities give Sylvie an insight into the scale of the problems.
Monsieur is the president of the artisan for the fishery, and he wants to say the problem they have is all the country who can't have the fish anymore in their own country, they come and they fish here. And in Senegal, it's the only thing they have to live, you know. And those people, they don't even come legally. They fish without license, without paying anything, and they just empty the sea. So it affects the whole population in a way that economically they can't survive. There is not enough fish for Africa, and there is not enough fish for Senegal. They said that they are reduced to fish the small fish instead of letting them grow. So they are fishing their future, basically.
Illegal fishing causes other unwanted side effects, and the Senegalese Minister for Ecology is taking Sylvie to see a Spanish tuna trawler that's run aground just off the coast.
So the problem is that this boat hit the island here and is sinking, but there is some gasoil in it. So they're pumping the petrol out. And they also try to take off this net. It's an enormous net that doesn't make the difference between a tuna or a shark or whatever. It takes everything, kills everything. So it's better if it's out of the sea. So they're going to take care of it.
Here we have two tanks of gasoline. And we put here the first pump, and we take the gasoline, because we need that they don't go to the sea. It's difficult because here we have some waves, the boat is moving, and we have to go fast because the sea can be strong.
With limited resources at his disposal, the minister is hoping for sea shepherds' assistance in the future to help patrol and survey Senegalese waters.